Another day in the music business requires another Music Biz Daily video. What's up, guys? My name is Matei, and today's story or today thing that I want to talk about is an article from Rolling Stones about Bob Dylan selling his entire catalog to Universal Music Publishing, or the entire catalog minus the very last album he just put out. So kind of let's break that down a little bit and what that means, because the point of this video is to sort of just high level highlight what publishing really is, because I think a lot of artists and producers get this confused. So Bob Dylan luckily has owned pretty much publishing the writing and the melodies aspect on all of the songs since like 1967. Well, 1967 he got signed. He didn't own his own publishing just yet, but a few years after he regained control of all of his own publishing. And after that, he did have multiple publishing deals throughout the years, but he always controlled the publishing, you know, aspect of it. Even when he had a deal, he was still the 100% copyright over of those, melodies and lyrics for all of his songs. Another unique thing about Bob Dylan is that majority of his songs were written entirely by himself. He's a great songwriter, you know, and a lot of people in the industry do say that being a great songwriter is the key ingredient behind the art part. Like, you know, being a great songwriter can assure a longevity in your career as a musician. But he was unique in the way that majority of his songs are entirely written by him, which makes it easier on the publishing administrative tasks, because there's no splits, there's no extra checks to be sent to or legal paperwork to all the different artists he collaborated. There are a few collaborations that he made, but that was a unique part about his particular catalog. Now, the reason, you know, Universal Music Publishing was interested in this is, A, it's worth a lot of money. It was an undisclosed amount, but they, you know, evaluate his entire catalog at around like $300 million, which, interestingly enough, that's what Taylor Swift's catalog was sold for by Scooter Braun. Anyways, going back to Bob Dylan's publishing. So one of the reasons that Universal Music Publishing bought the rights to his entire catalog, at least according to this article, is because Bob Dylan is one of the most covered artists on this planet, right? You may not think it, because some, you know, for your youngins, a lot of the covers you're looking at, you know, are probably of like Selena Gomez, Justin Bieber, or like, you know, these new artists that are, you know, Cardi B, whatever, Rihanna. But when you think about all the cover bands that like play top 40 hits, or, you know, all the summer festivals, or all the wine festivals and beer festivals and all these different things, you know, that kind of just like draw a crowd of, you know, random masses, especially the older generations, like 40 and above, a lot of those songs are Bob Dylan. And a lot of these covers, guess what they have to do in order to license them properly and to be able to play these covers to either make money off of it or just to be able to legally use them? That's when you get paid on publishing, right? And this is the difference I want to explain. So for example, you put out a song and let's say you own 20% on publishing on it as a producer, and the artist and their team and the label is marketing it, that doesn't mean that you're gonna get 20% of the revenue of that song or royalty. The royalty is separate from the publishing. The publishing is the intellectual property. So if somebody else decides to use your production, your melody as a producer in another song to do a remix or to do a cover, or somehow somebody remakes that instrumental into a piece that's gonna go into a motion picture or something like that, that's when you start making on publishing, you know, making money on publishing, additional money. So if you were to just, for the artist, however, he makes money on publishing because his own song is being played. You know, publishing also gets covered through ASCAP and things like that. The writer, publishing royalties. But basically, publishing is not royalty from revenue, from streaming on, you know, saying Spotify and all that, unless somebody else is licensing a remix of your written lyric work or the melody work, right? Because you can also write music, like on a note sheet. So that's when publishing becomes important. And because Bob Dylan happens to be one of the most covered artists in the world, that's why it's so lucrative for Universal Music Group to buy it, because there's gonna be so many bands and video game makers, potentially movies, motion pictures, all these different, you know, content creators continue to utilize the written work, the lyrics and the melodies that Bob Dylan has created. Now, if you have an artist that, even though they have really dope music, but nobody else, no other artists are covering them, no, you know, movies want to like take their work and all of that. Buying the catalog of the publishing rights is not that lucrative, because as a publisher, what you need to make is that you sell or exploit the intellectual property behind that song. Just the song itself of the artist being streamed, all that, that's royalty revenue that, you know, that's slightly different. But the publishing only becomes lucrative if that artist is timeless and many other content creators want to license that work. So I just wanted to talk about this deal to sort of go, you know, get back to the topic of publishing, because look, publishing, royalties, copyrights and all this type of stuff is not necessarily the simplest thing to understand. And certain labels or certain deals want to overcomplicate how it's administered, divided, paid for, and all of that. And it could get very complex. I mean, you know, whatever's in the contract could be the deal. You know what I'm saying? There's 101 different ways to split it up, to associate what's what and all of that. So I just wanted to kind of explain high level, again, what is publishing, is the intellectual property behind that particular song. And that's why the Bob Dylan deal in particular is lucrative for Universal Music Publishing. So I'm gonna leave you with that. If you have any more questions on publishing or copyrights and all that, you know, definitely hit me up in the comments. But I made in the last 30-day Music Biz advice challenge that I had those videos. I had two specific videos on these topics. So definitely go back and rewatch those. But as always, in the comments, save the video, like it, share it with somebody who needs to see this. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.